Every 2 years, the International University Sports Federation organizes a summer universiade. But alongside the competitions themselves, FISU also holds a major conference on its global role. It signs contracts with other important organizations. This year, for example, the World Anti-Doping Agency. And it offers student seminars on subjects like the curse of doping and contact with the media, because the Universiade is often their first contact with the international press.
Well, there's many thousands of young people here, and they're looking for their future careers, whether it's in sport or outside of sport, how to use the media, where to be careful when dealing with the media, and how to adapt and also understand, because even though the media is all around us, there's still some misunderstandings about how the media work.
FISU provides classes for the students to learn how to respond and how to act in front of the press and the cameras.
Yeah, it was very important to know about the media because we speak to media every day and then we say things that we don't mean on media only to find out that it breaks our reputation. So now I've learned what to do and what not to do when you're dealing with the media.
Well, first, the main thing I tell them is be yourself. Don't try and pretend to be something that you're not. But prepare if you're talking to a journalist or anyone in the media. Think about what points you want to get across. Think about the worst case scenario. Think about some questions that you don't want to face, but prepare for them anyway, because the media is unpredictable.
During the Universiade, any athlete might get interviewed, and the first impression they present of themselves could follow them throughout their whole career.
The journalist is very important for the athletes since they are building their reputation and making the events so people can see them. So without journalists, sports would not be as popular. So I think that's important to have a good relationship between the athletes and the journalists.
Well, there's still a lot of curiosity about how the media works. The obvious question is, why do we hear so much bad news and why is there not more good news? They also want to know the impact of social media on the more traditional media and also what are the motivations of the media? Why do we ask certain questions? And it's also up to me to explain the mechanics. The most obvious thing is to be quite quick and concise, because when people speak to the media, they often feel they're misrepresented, because we in the media, just by the mechanics of our job, we have to be very brief and concise and just take a small part of what they've said.
The young athletes come from different cultures and different horizons, where their local media doesn't have the same influence, perhaps, or the same impact.
I've learned so many things in the seminar that I didn't know, and then so far some good. I'm gonna give other people this information that I got today, and then thanks to FISU for organizing this seminar.
So athletes can get to know how to deal with the press. But they can also learn how the media works, because FISU puts together a learning program at major events like the World University Games for wannabe journalists.
We started in 2011 at the Universiade in Shenzhen, and we thought, beside of reporting about the Universiade, we would like to have some kind of educational program to teach young reporters, young sport reporters, to behave, how to behave at a multi-sport event, but also to assist the FISU media in covering the games.
They come from all over the world, representing a huge diversity of cultures. It's an all-around education in the media, including covering the Universiade every afternoon.
The most difficult is that to make them realize that they're not here to write about sports, but about human interest. We had somebody from Egypt who loved football, and he thought, you know, he's going to write the best stories of football of his life here. And he said, no, you're not going to write about football. So he was disappointed at the very beginning. And he said, well, I can only write about football. And now he realized he can do so much more than only write about football. So that's a great challenge we have, and it's also a great outcome that we have from the program.
We are more focused here on the personality stories, and we have really nice stories here. We give a voice to small delegations, we give a voice to the volunteers, the judges, And so this is the whole picture now of the Universiade, because competition is one part, but we have more parts inside of the Universiade.
12 young men and women from abroad took part, plus 12 Koreans, all tasked with getting hold of their information, finding contacts, learning how a press center or a television center works. A fortnight to soak up as much knowledge as possible.
They have to bring us 3 stories a day with different deadlines. And they have to be very creative in the sense that the majority of athletes here are unknown athletes. They're athletes that will become known after the Universiade when they go to World Championships or Olympics. But here they're not known. So they have to find peculiar stories about athletes. They have to do some research. And to do that, they have to work hard.
Between meetings and reports, the young journalists would go on site. On this day, after classes in the morning, Chidiyeberi Ezeani from Nigeria would follow the athletics.
I'm with the Young Reporters Program with the FISU. So my situation here today was to come here, witness the event, because you can't write an accurate story without witnessing the event. So for me, it's been all about witnessing the event and writing an accurate story, which is number one.
10 finals would take place, a busy program on track and field, the high jump competition, throwing and running, including the relays, the Nigerian having to take notes and make some choices too.
For me today, it's been meeting the winners, because it's not easy out there. And then you see the excitement written all over their face when they win. And of course, also meeting also those who didn't win, but who are optimistic for the next time or something like that. So it's been exciting.
After the finals, Chidiyeberi would walk down into the mix zone to get more information and that reaction as well.
At a major competition. I'm with the FISU Media.
Okay.
You won the
high jump.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah, thank you.
It's a big thing. It's a gold medal.
Yeah, it's a gold medal. I'm very happy for that because I've never won a gold medal in the World University Games. It was my first time when I won a silver medal.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, that's good. Congratulations again.
Thank you.
You know, it was quite enlightening to know that there's a lot beyond the scoreline and there's a lot beyond who won the event. There's the crowd, the reactions, and of course the atmosphere around the stadium. And of course, there are other hidden stories, like some survival story. You have athletes who survived cancer, you know, and those are stories that left to me I wouldn't do.
Like every other journalist, Chidiyeberi then walks over to the press room to get her notes in order, sort out her article, and tell us what she learned during these university games.
For me, it used to be all football or nothing. But right now, I've gotten experience. The experience for me has been overwhelming. I have been able to cover all the sporting events. So definitely, my mindset and my approach to sports reporting has definitely changed. And it has changed definitely for good. But the Young Reporters Program has opened me to such marvelous knowledge that I think, for me, I'm a better writer. Right now, for me, I already feel like a professional and I can go into any event knowing that I actually know what I'm going to do then.
The program really can act as a launch pad to a journalistic career.
I think first of all, they get to know here sports they never saw before. So it's not only football here at the Universiade. We have sports like fencing or diving they never report before. They know how to behave or to act as a journalist because they do the normal journalistic or reporting work. But it's a win-win situation because after that program, they can become a freelancer in FISU, in a U Media team. That means if they are interested in university sport for a longer time, they can work for FISU in their country and report about their country or their region. So it's really a win-win situation. They get skills and knowledge here, but we would like to use them in the future.
For these young reporters, it also develops an awareness of university sport in their respective countries.
I'm going to try, of course, to influence other people, but of course, I'm going to do that in my writing, when I write or be on screen or on radio in my country. I'm going to try as much as possible to deviate a little bit from football, because in Nigeria, it's almost all about football, and try to create better awareness for our country, because yes, we were at the university this summer, but we didn't get any medals, and it's something that the team needs to build on, the country needs to build on. We need to invest in university sports, we need to invest in grassroots sports, and not just football. So for me, this has created an avenue, and I'm going to use the opportunity to try to influence the way we can approach school sports, because it's actually very important.
A FISU initiative that's already producing results. Still to come on Campus Sport, the French put their rivals to the sword. Plus, the last word on the 2015 games and a look ahead with the Universiad director.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.